There are five major reasons why you might want to consider starting a career in IT security. First, there's much more demand for qualified IT security professionals than supply. Recent trends, including the increased number of successful security attacks and regulatory requirements for strong security, are driving demand for IT security professionals. Second, once you have your IT security job, as long as you're effective in your role, you can expect long-term job security. Because good IT security professionals are so hard to find, a smart organization will want you to stay as long as possible. There are many types of IT security jobs to choose from. You shouldn't have any problem finding a job that fits your skill set, experience, personality, and career aspirations. Fourth, there is plenty of career growth potential when you have an IT security job. You can start out as a brand new IT security technician and take your career all the way to an IT security director if that's your desire. And finally, a great reason to start a career in IT security is you'll probably get paid more. The 2015 Burning Glass Cybersecurity Jobs Report identified a security premium of 9% compared to other IT workers. In other words, IT security professionals can expect to get an average salary premium of nearly $6,500 per year because their skills are in such high demand. These five reasons are why many people are seriously considering starting a career in IT security. Let's take a look at some of the key events in IT security history. This quick history lesson will give some context to the quickly evolving world of IT security and the growing need for security professionals. The timeline starts in 1969 when ARPANET, the precursor to the Internet, sent its first message. TCP/IP, the same transmission protocol we use on the Internet today, was tested for the first time 6 years later in 1975. In 1983, ARPANET began using TCP/IP, bringing it one step closer to the Internet we know today. The Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, which criminalized many forms of computer hacks and attacks, was passed by the United States Congress in 1986. In 1988, the first major network worm was released by Robert Tappan Morris, crippling thousands of computers and causing millions in estimated damages. The Morris worm led to the creation of the U.S. Computer Emergency Response Team Coordination Center, or CERT-CC, later that year. Morris was the first person convicted under the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. In 1990, the Internet as we know it was born when ARPANET was decommissioned. In the U.S., the 1990s brought us laws and standards still important to us today. The Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, or HIPAA, defined security safeguards for electronic protected health information, or EPHI. The Gramm-Leach-Bliley Act, or GLBA, included a safeguards rule requiring financial institutions to develop a written information security plan to protect clients' non-public personal information. In the early 2000s, more U.S. laws and standards were established, including the Federal Information Security Management Act, or FISMA, which requires all U.S. federal agencies to develop, document, and implement an information security program. In 2002, California became the first state to require companies who have suffered a data breach to notify their customers. Then, in 2004, the Payment Card Industry Data Security Standards, or PCI-DSS, outlined the basic security levels for merchants who store, process, and transmit cardholder data. In the late 2000s, the number of hacks and attacks continued to increase, starting with the TJ Maxx hack in 2005, which led to the theft of 45 million customer credit and debit account details. Also in 2005, the ISO IEC 27001 was published as an international security standard, which is still used today as the basis for organizations' security policies. From 2010 to 2015, we saw a major spike in hacks and attacks. Government, healthcare, technology, and finance are just a few of the many industries that have suffered data breaches. Altogether, many millions of sensitive organizations and personal records were breached over these 5 years. As you can see, a lot has happened in the world of IT security since 1969. Two major trends are evident in these events. The first is that cyber threats are becoming more sophisticated, frequent, and successful. No one is safe from a cyber attack. Another significant trend is the increasing need for IT security professionals due to regulatory requirements for stronger security, organizations seeking to protect themselves from cyber threats, and customer demands that businesses protect their sensitive information. You should now see why businesses and organizations worldwide seek qualified security professionals to help protect their systems and data. One of the benefits of being in the IT security industry is the great variety of resources available which can enhance your career. Some of these resources are educational, while others are more entertaining, but luckily, many of them are free. We'll start with a few general security resources. The National Institute of Standards and Technology, or NIST, maintains a Computer Security Resource Center. The CSRC is a helpful site when you're looking for examples of security policies and standards, especially if you're writing these for your organization and you need some inspiration. Next is CERIAS, the Center for Education and Research in Information Assurance and Security at Purdue University. Here you'll find free IT security seminars plus industry news and opinion. And you'll want to check out the SANS Reading Room, where you can reference more than 2,500 IT security white papers written by other IT security professionals. As an IT security professional, people will expect you to know and have an opinion about current security events. You can stay on top of IT security news, events, and trends by reading these blogs: Krebs on Security, Naked Security, Threat Level, Dark Reading, Threat Post, and Information Security Magazine. Sometimes it's easier to listen to security news and commentary, so you might enjoy these popular security podcasts: Breaking Down Security, Down the Security Rabbit Hole, Southern Fried Security Podcast, Security Current Podcast, and the SANS Internet Storm Center Daily Podcast. There is no lack of paid training opportunities in the IT security field, but there are also high-quality free training resources if you know where to look. Check out these free trainings if you need to expand your knowledge in these areas. Cybrary, which provides free IT security training on a wide variety of topics, including many certification exams. Metasploit Unleashed, a free course on ethical hacking using the Metasploit framework. CISSP Cryptography Mini Course, a free course covering the basics of cryptography. And SANS Cyber Aces, which provides courses on fundamental IT security topics like operating systems, networking, and system administration. For a mix of education and entertainment, there are plenty of great IT security books worth reading. Schneier on Security is a great read that explores security expert Bruce Schneier's security philosophy. There are also four riveting titles that tell real stories of hacking, espionage, and cybercrime. Ghost in the Wires, My Adventure as the World's Most Wanted Hacker by Kevin Mitnick. Spam Nation, The Inside Story of Organized Cybercrime from Global Epidemic to Your Front Door by Brian Krebs. The Cuckoo's Egg, Tracking a Spy Through the Maze of Computer Espionage by Cliff Stahl. And finally, Kingpin, How One Hacker Took Over the $1 Billion Cybercrime Underground by Kevin Paulson. Of course, there are many more resources for IT security professionals than the ones I've covered here. And as you progress in your career, you'll find your own favorites. In the ever-changing world of IT security, the most important factor when determining where you get your news is data quality.